I think I was a good kid. I think I wanted to please my parents. Yeah, life was awesome. Life was incredible. I had a you know, a dad as a best friend, a dad who came to all my soccer games, a mum who was incredible, who loved me more, you know, than herself. Saw a lot of selfless love within my family. We'd go to church every Sunday and I'd go to Sunday school. And they were a massive influence in my life. I got into hip hop at a sort of early high school age. That really shaped me as a person. I didn't really do a whole lot of stuff that I considered to be that sort of wrong, but I was hanging out with a lot of dudes who were, you know, I did get a lot involved in graffiti on the train lines and that kind of thing, but I'd justify it. You know, it wasn't someone's personal property, so therefore it's not a bad thing. I'm just expressing myself. I got diabetes when I was 15, so I learned they had to inject like 4 needles a day, but I always sort of believed that it would stop me from getting into trouble more. So I was meant to watch your drinking and watch smoking and things like that. So I always saw diabetes as quite a positive thing in my life. I don't think I knew what the gospel was at all. I think I knew that God was like a bigger dad than mine, and he had an eye on me, and I needed to make sure that I wasn't stuffing up. I knew God was there, and I knew that I needed to follow him as a God, but there was no real relationship there because, you know, I was invincible, man. Like, death wasn't a thing. I had my 21st birthday, which was really quite a humongous sort of party, but it was 6 days after that Dad lost his struggle with depression. I think I tried to cope really well, and I would say I wasn't bitter at God, but when you look back at it, like, I knew God still loved me. I didn't really find myself getting angry at God, but I definitely wasn't living a life pleasing to God. So I think I handled it like a lot of people would, and I ran and didn't really look after my diabetes a lot. And just sort of getting up to what you do at that age, going out a lot, you know, drinking a lot, drinking at home a lot, that kind of thing. Sort of, you know, struggled at home with it. So I think what I was actually doing was I was using God a lot and not giving back. So I was, you know, praying to God a lot in these situations and asking for help and asking for him to look after my mum and whatnot. But I wasn't living a life, man, that was pleasing to him, you know what I mean? I was sort of just asking a lot and not giving at all. When you're invincible, I think the Bible and you know, the gospel's nice. But I think when you're broken, man, it's life, you know what I mean? It's really, I knew I needed it. It was the most stable thing my whole life. And that's what killed the anxiety, man. I think when I really got into scripture, that's when I had this filter going, hang on, God loves me. God, nothing will separate me from the love of God through Jesus in Romans. These are all filters that I got in my life, you know what I mean? Like, reading scripture and going through these hard times and all these things that happen to me now, it's only because from that broken state where I was that I realized that, you know, God hit me hard with the gospel. And I just think that it completely changed my mind. It changed my life, man. Yeah.